Hey everyone, welcome back to Twinkle Tunes and Lighting. Today is our last video in our series of six. We're talking about your display. It's time to put all your ideas, all your hard work, and stick it in your yard and make it look cool. Here we go. What exactly are display props? Okay, these are props that you may build, that you can buy, that you can design. These are physical decorations or objects that you've attached your LEDs or bullet pixels to highlight your story in your show. Think of candy canes or stars or snowflakes or even characters like Santa Claus, Snoopy, a talking pumpkin, a singing witch, a cauldron that smokes perhaps. All lit up with your pixels to give it shape, to give it color, to give it dimension, to give it depth. These are what makes your show go beyond lights just on your house. Props are a game changer because it gives your display depth and subject than just looking at your house with lights on it. It gives it some dynamics so people come by, watch your show, and they remember it. These props can be themed elements wrapped around whatever subject that you're trying to display. For beginners, they're also a great way just to ease into the hobby without a bunch of complex programming or scripting or anything like that. All right, let's look at some starter props. These are props that you can go online, make a couple clicks, buy some, they ship them to your house, you pop your pixels in them, and you're ready to go. In X-Lights, there's a big chance that that prop is already into the software. So all you have to do is drag it on to your surface and onto your display, and you're ready to go. Now you can also do some DIY kind of wireframes and put your pixels around whatever you designed. You'll need to go into the software and tell where your pixels are in your DIY prop, but that's super easy. So you can build your own props. And another popular prop that people do is just a flat wooden cutout, some kind of scene or character, and it's lined out with the pixels. So it just kind of brings luminescence to that picture or that painting or that prop that they've built. Each has its benefits depending on your skill set and however you want to design your show. When you pick your props, you want to think about the overall design and theme of your show. Once again, everyone's taste is different. I like mine where I've got all coral props and that's the look of my show. I don't try to mix matrixes or TVs or try to put in projectors or anything like that. Mine are just strictly bullet pixels and that's what my whole show looks like. It's 100% bullet pixels and it's beautiful. Some people like to mix and match and they put a Santa Claus and they make a cutout and they have a cool little reindeer and things like that. It's whatever you want. But you gotta think of your theme and how you're gonna place these things. Make them not look like just a hodgepodge of props you put out there and you know, the Coroplast just threw up on your lawn and that's what you get. All right, think it out, make it look really pretty. Sometimes less is better, sometimes more is better. Our props live outdoors the whole time. I usually put mine out at the beginning of right around kind of November-ish, and that'll take them down to about the end of January. And they sit outside the whole time. So if you're making props and you're making your cables, you want to make sure that you've got waterproof connectors. You want to make sure that your props can sit out in the elements if you're in cold weather, the snow and rain and the wind. And so you need to keep in mind that that prop's gonna sit out there and get abused for the next 3 months. I also like to make my cables nice and neat on my lawn and then stake them down to where it's safe, because a lot of people like to come up, deliver packages, and they don't want to trip over your cables. Plus, it makes it look nice. You want to be able to troubleshoot and be able to look at your own display and have it look pretty during the day as well. Some people don't. I do. I like to have a pretty display. I like to have good curb appeal, so when my neighbors drive by, it just doesn't look like a yard sale of props, but it looks somewhat kind of configured. They go, oh man, this is gonna be cool. We should go there tonight. Go check it out. You don't need to spend a fortune to make some cool props. I've made a lot of my own props out of stuff that's just, you can go down to the big box store and you can buy simple materials and have a really cool, effective prop. Like PVC, or going down to the dollar store and getting the plastic cutouts, anything like that, you can convert those into a prop. Drill some holes, put your lights in it, and next thing you know, now you got this really cool customized prop. A couple of my favorite props that I use, I love the spiders and the singing pumpkins for Halloween. I love the singing Christmas tree and singing light bulbs for Christmas. I really like my spinners. I really like my snowflakes. I like my lollipops. I've bought all these props and I've made a lot of them. So those are some of my favorite ones. I really, really like my leaping arches. My leaping arches I built from scratch. I found other people that have built them. I kind of took some of their ideas, added some of my own ideas. I've got a video on how to make these cool leaping arches if you want to guys check that out. But I like those a lot. Leaping arches really give it a lot of a visual, a lot of movement in your yard. So those are some of my favorite effects and some of my favorite props. If you're running out of ideas or need help, go on Facebook, go on YouTube, and look up people's designs and people's recordings of their houses and their shows. You will find some of the coolest things that people are doing. Believe me, if you thought of it, someone else is already doing it, and maybe they have a better way, and maybe they don't. A lot of times I look at these other designers out there and I see a prop and I'm like, that's not how I would use it, but I do like that prop, and so I'll put it into my show. So these are great things to do. Get ideas and brainstorm. And this community that you now belong to, you can throw out and have great conversations and people will help you. Okay? It's a very, very friendly community that's out there. That's it for our 6-part series. Thanks so much for watching. Look at my other videos for some of these advanced controller builds, some tools that I use. These things will help you out as you progress and get bigger and start spending more money and start decorating your house more. You're gonna wanna have all these tutorials to figure it out. Thanks again for watching. Like and subscribe, hit the bell icon, and we'll see you next time. Here, check out that video. This video here, that's a cool one. That's a cool controller I built. And then you got this one here. That's how you build some of those leaping arches. I like those. Those are cool. You can like and subscribe over here. That's pretty neat. That's good stuff.